In the hot seat today, FairPoint executives facing some tough questions from regulators from Maine, New Hampshire, and Vermont, all unhappy about the number of customer complaints lodged against the telecommunications giant. It started shortly after FairPoint bought telephone and internet service operations from Verizon last year. Since then, the company has been plagued with customer service and system problems. Over the winter, the company released a 9-page stabilization plan requested by the Maine Public Utilities Commission. This afternoon, officials from all three northern New England states got together for the first time to question FairPoint. News 8's Keith Baldi live from Derry, New Hampshire, with our Project Economy coverage tonight. Keith?
Well, good evening, Tori. This FairPoint hearing was long, and they went over a lot of complex issues. But the bottom line is that FairPoint says they're working to make things better and at the same time stave off filing for bankruptcy.
Yes.
It was a who's who of FairPoint execs face-to-face with utility commissioners from northern New England. Those regulators were interested in one thing, determining why FairPoint has been unable to meet the demands of its customers.
What I don't see is a detailed action plan for fixing the problems. It's been 7 months since the cutover. When should we expect such a plan, and when do you expect to finally correct the problems?
That basic question was not answered in a way commissioners were hoping it would be, but instead with a response by FairPoint's CEO, who says by November they will be able to propose a comprehensive solution.
We're not to the point we have the final timeline. We are at the point where it's time to develop the plan.
The CEO and his team said they have solved some of the issues plaguing the company in Maine, Vermont, and New Hampshire, like excessive wait times for customers. Now it takes about 18 seconds, they say, to get a representative on the phone. They've also reorganized to manage projects better and cut down on billing errors. But according to utilities regulators, the company has not fixed everything.
But some of these people, their order hasn't even been submitted after 30 days.
And although FairPoint representatives say customer numbers and satisfaction are going in the right direction, they also admit that the effects of the systems changeover from Verizon were significant, and for the first time suggested that a bankruptcy filing may be in the offing.
We are considering all other restructuring alternatives available to us, which may include the commencement of an in-court resolution under Chapter 11 of the U.S. Bankruptcy Code.
That, along with the lack of concrete answers and a specific timeline, was enough to make Maine's deputy public advocate increasingly concerned. He says to date, FairPoint hasn't even completed cutting over to its own systems 6 months after they started.
That problem is causing them to lose revenues, to lose customers, and it's going to make it difficult to operate.
Are you worried?
Everybody should be worried.
Regulators will now go back to their individual states and go over the testimony. The CEO of FairPoint tells me he will make a decision about the bankruptcy in the next few months. We're live in Derry, New Hampshire. Keith Baldi, News 8.